What's up, everyone? I'm Max Dalton, and in this video, I'll show you how to use Safari extensions on your Apple iPhone or iPad. With the release of iOS 15 for iPhone and iPad, Apple is finally introducing the ability to use extensions in its Safari web browser. Extensions don't have to be installed separately, but if you want to use an extension in Safari, you will need to have the associated app installed for the extension to be available. Using extensions in Safari lets you integrate content from that app into Safari or gives you the ability to easily send data between Safari and that specific app. Now let's walk through the steps to use Safari extensions on your Apple iPhone or iPad. Step 1. Launch the Settings app on your iPhone or iPad. You'll land on the Settings screen. Step 2. Scroll down this menu and then tap Safari. Options for Safari will be displayed. Step 3. Scroll down to the General section in the Safari menu and then tap Extensions. The Extensions screen is displayed where you'll see the available extensions that are associated with any apps you have installed. In this example, I don't have any apps with available extensions. Step 4. Tap More Extensions. You'll be taken out to a Safari extension screen where you'll see available apps you can install that have extensions in Safari on your iPhone or iPad. Step 5. Tap to install the app associated with the extension you want to use in Safari. In this example, I'll install the 1Password app. Step 6. Now open the Safari web browser on your Apple iPhone or iPad and then tap the extensions icon on the right side of the address bar. The extensions icon looks like a puzzle piece. The Manage Extensions window opens. Step 7. Tap Manage Extensions. A bigger Manage Extensions window is shown, displaying a list of all available extensions you can use in Safari. Step 8. Tap to toggle on any extensions you want to use, and then tap Done. The window will close and you'll be taken back to the Safari home screen where you can confirm your extension is active by checking to make sure you see its associated icon in the address bar. You can navigate back to the Manage Extension screen at any time to turn your extension off so it doesn't display in the address bar. And finally, you can't uninstall a Safari extension on your iPhone or iPad individually, and the extension will only be removed from the list of available extensions after you uninstall the associated app from your iPhone or iPad. Let me know if this video helped you out in the comments below. If you liked what you saw here, click the video links on the right side of the screen to check out another video. Or click the logo on the left side of the screen to check out my tutorial website at www.maxdalton.how.